the Section 8 housing was 2 years, a year to 2 year waiting list if I was to apply and be eligible. So, you know, it's just for me, I was just like praying to God. You know, I used to call some of my close ones, you know, my mom, my dad, my people I went to college with, people I'm home close to. But sometimes at the same time, I wasn't trying to let them know what I was going through.
Right, you don't want them to worry?
You don't want to worry. One, you don't want them to worry. It's like, it's kind of discouraging. Like, when I say discouraging, it kind of felt embarrassed. It's like, everyone seen me going to California, like, oh yeah, you got a new job and he's doing this thing. And then it's like, I get there and I'm struggling. You know, I'm out here struggling. And it's like, man, it kind of felt, it was like an embarrassment. Like, and I feel like that's a psychological thing for other homeless people as well. Because they feel either embarrassed or they feel they don't have the courage to go and stand up or go and get a job or go to an interview because they feel as if they're nothing. They don't fit. They don't look the part. They don't, you know, they don't look appealing to others. So I feel like that plays a big role, like psychologically.
Right. I could imagine, like, it's probably stressful. And, you know, on top of that, the shame. And like you're saying, the psychological effects that it has on you is tough.
Yeah, it is. It is. Because especially like some of the kids found out that I was homeless. Like, I was sleeping in my car because they'll walk by in the morning time and I'll be asleep, like, in the car. And some of the kids like, oh, yeah, AC sleeps in his car. They call me Ace, Coach AC. Like, oh, AC sleeps in his car, da, da, da. And they always ask, like, yeah, where do you live at? And I can never give them an answer. Like, oh, yeah, I live around the way. Like, yeah, you know, I was already here in the morning. God just make things up. Right. So they didn't really know. And that was even to the teachers, too, because teachers were asked. I'm like, oh, no, nah, yeah, I'm good. So the only people that knew was actually the principal and the assistant principal. That's like, I couldn't own it then. Like, at that point in time, while I was homeless, I couldn't own being homeless. But now I can own it. I overcame it. So it's like, now I can kind of speak on that and kind of give hope to people who are in the transitional stage of being homeless.